Do you think it could be argued that, however, that in company painting, and even, in fact, in Bhupen Khakhar, the hybridity is there, that the match is a little less homogeneous? It's almost, and then something is altered.
Well, that kind of hybridity is what interests me, and I think in a way it also interested Bhupen very much. And this is something which I still argue about. See, you don't have to merge everything to make it into a homogeneous entity. I think that kind of a homogeneous entity is the end, it is the death. What is the dynamism of these living elements in interaction with each other, even conflicting, is something which is, I think, close to life in some ways. And I think that is what I like to keep alive, you know, that. And I saw that Hamzanama was an actual specimen of that, which was painted at the Court of Akbar. It is the story which is often considered to be the story of, name is associated with Prophet's uncle, but it was also a rebel in the time of Harun al-Rashid. So, but it's a fictional story, a fictional tale. I think there are hundreds of stories. They were oral tales. And these were narrated to Akbar, Emperor Akbar, the Mughal emperor. And so he, I think it looks that he made his artist to paint it. And this was painted for 15 years, in which Indian, Persian, and Indian and Persian artists were involved, who also incorporated elements from European art. Because at the court of Akbar, the Portuguese missionaries had brought plantains, polygraph Bible, with illustrations, I think they were etchings from Antwerp, if I am not mistaken. And these served as a basis for them to, let us say, incorporate within their kind of naturalism that they had developed. So Persian, there is a particular kind of naturalism that is in 15th, 16th century Persian painting. Indian painting had its own way of looking at both the world and also articulating in basically in human form a kind of naturalism, and this was the third. And I think what came together in the form of interaction was Hamzanama. When the same idiom is applied in a more homogeneous form in the life story of Akbar, you find that it has lost the spark. It has lost that kind of energy and also the kind of dynamism which Hamzanama displays.
Can I just say, isn't the point for you partly that the artists from the different regions and even from different, totally different traditions, yeah, were working together on the same sheet?
Often, yes.
Which is,
well, I would not be surprised to go back to Ajanta and say that there were multiple guilds and not one from India. And when you say guilds, you know, if they came from south, that would be an entirely different tradition than the guild that was from the north. Because the north would mean as far as, let us say, you know, Kandahar, Afghanistan, etc., because that tradition had traveled that far. What I'm trying to articulate is the fact that even in the paintings like Ajanta, there would be multiple hands. Because it's a project which was an epic project, such a large project in which you would have to. And then they were painted at different periods of time, sometimes not with great gap between them. Let's say after 30 years another group came and painted that wall, or sometimes even finished that wall which was left unfinished by the other. But it is also quite likely that the guild shared their craftsmen, guild shared their artists. You know, if somebody was sick or ill and was not available, they would borrow somebody, you know, some other skill. Well, that is one thing. But at the Mughal court, it was an experiment. It was undertaken as a kind of a great experiment to, in one sense, I think it is to define the great plurality of India. I think it was done through art. Well, Akbar, as you know, was interested in belief systems, in religion. So he used to collect all these, representatives of different faiths. He had the Jain monks, he had the Hindu scholars, he had the Persian scholars, he also had the Portuguese missionaries. So,
and he used to have these... He even had Jews.
He was interested. In fact, he even, what shall I say, composed a new religion, if I may use that word. Deen-e-Ilahi, the religion of the Lord or God, which incorporated all these elements. And I think it is to his credit that he didn't enforce it. And so it didn't become a kind of a religion. But I have learned that there are few families who worked for Akbar. Their successors continued to follow. I have even come to know of a family who was in Ahmedabad. Anyway, but the painting was the major experiment. And I think it was at the workshop in either in Delhi or in Agra, but mostly in Delhi, where these painters, the great masters, whom they call Ustad, who would make a drawing. There would be those who would be well-versed in, let us say, landscape or those who would be well-versed in certain kind of figuration or portraiture, those who would be adept at doing certain kind of finance patterns or architecture, and their hands would be brought together on a single folio. And Hamza was the, what shall we call it? This was the breeding ground. This is where it happened. They actually did that. And Hamza is a very different kind of experiment because it's not small miniature. It's not a small folio picture. It's a large. It's on cloth. It's painted on cloth. And there were 1,400 pictures painted. If you put them sideways, it would be more than space of a kilometer. And that was for 15 years all these people were engaged in, where they tried to hone their own skills into bringing alive story of a hero who was perhaps fictional, but in a way they had, in the example of the emperor, a kind of a character. So they created Hamza in a way. It's not so much the kind of a literary story as actually the story of the life of people. And what came in the process was a vast canvas of the Indian countryside, vast kind of a horde of characters, of demons. I think there are no demons of that kind painted ever. We only paint gods and goddesses, but these kinds of demons that they are painted are amazing. And they are all very, charged figures. They are not sort of very finely finished figures. They are sort of half done at times. And I think that is where lies the greatness of that